Thank you all for finding time and visiting today's webinar. We welcome you and we appreciate. So welcome to Kobe Maharashtra's first webinar titled How to Sell on Instagram. So I will be moderating the session. I am Sonali Desai. I am the founder of a sustainable fashion brand called Weaving Roots. And I'm also a writer and a journalist. So we also have amongst us our national president, Ms. Vandana Maheshwari and Ms. Madhu Tyagi, who's our national vice president. We welcome both of them to our today's session. So I don't know how many of you all know, but June 30th was World Social Media Day. And although this session wasn't planned to commemorate this particular day, but it just goes to show that how important and how relevant social media has become in our lives. So moving on. Why are we here today is pretty much clear, but how we got here? Well, in 2004, many years ago, six successful first generation women entrepreneurs were thoughtful and broke stereotypes and barriers to create this business platform exclusively for women. And they called it COWE, Confederation of Women Entrepreneurs of India. Today, COWE is a registered technical agency under NIMSME. It is on the board of MSME and NSIC of the Government of India. Its main partners are MSME, NSIC, SBI, NABARD, SIDBI, and the Industries and Commerce Department. In fact, SIDBI has appointed COWE as the hand-holding agency to give Philip to stand up to their Stand Up India scheme. Since its inception, thousands of women have benefited. It's more than 200 programs impacting lives of 10,000 women through these training programs. To know more on how you can capitalize on opportunities and grow with COWE, you can get in touch with us after the session. Before I introduce our expert speaker, let me explain how you can talk to us during the webinar. If you have any questions during the session, just write them to chat. We will take a Q&A session soon after we end the webinar. So now we can begin about the topic. Social media has come a long way, certainly. I still remember my first job as a journalist in Bangalore as a reporter was to write for the website team, the internet team. And I remember how print edition guys never took us seriously, how internet team was considered unimportant. And today, when we look at it, the journey of social media, it has not only evolved, it has grown, and it has shown how serious it is, like how you can do business here. And social media has gone to challenge newspapers and magazines and advertising billboards. And not just the media, Instagram is driving businesses crazy. So let's dive in and unearth what drives sales on Instagram. To guide us on this, I welcome Ms. Ami Savla Hemani, a social media expert, consultant, trainer, visiting faculty at NMIMS. She has trained 6,000 plus people till date, catered to training needs of many corporate clients, one being the French tourism. And she's the founder of a social media training hub called Socialize Store. She's bagged 9 awards, featured in 26 newspapers and magazines. Recently, she got interviewed by CNBC for their show Tech Guru. Also, she conducted multiple sessions for 1,000 plus doctors across 5 cities in India. Ms. Hemani, you can take it from here. Welcome.
Sonali, am I audible?
Yes, now you are.
Okay, perfect. So thank you so much, Sonali, and thank you, COWE, for inviting me on this wonderful platform today. I'm very, very happy and glad to have been a part of this platform today and meeting so many wonderful women out there. So very, very good afternoon to you all, and thank you so much once again. So before we start, you know, there's a small snippet that I would like to share about myself and why it's very important for everyone to be online today. Like, if you ask me my journey 5 years ago, I didn't know anything about social media. I was totally clueless. I didn't study anything about marketing. I haven't worked in any digital marketing agency, nothing of that sort. So when I was very young, I decided to have my first startup. To promote that startup, I had to actually go digital. So it was not my choice, but the startup forced me to go digital because I had to promote that startup. Now, to be very honest, the startup never saw the sunshine because it failed, and it failed miserably. Of course, it got me a lot of fame. Like, for that startup, I got featured in Times of India, DNA, and a lot of things happened, but it was not giving me money at the end of the day. Of course, after putting in a lot of effort, promoting it on social media, I realized that it's not going anywhere. Probably our people were not ready for the kind of concept that I was getting to them that time. So I decided to close that venture. But having said that, the things that I learned on social media because of that startup got me a new entry into a new world, and that is a digital marketing world. During that time, I realized the immense potential the startup has, the social media has. Because of that startup and because of social media, I could reach out to people from USA, from London, from different countries, and I created an amazing network, okay, which eventually started giving me a lot of business, you know. So I realized the immense capabilities the social media has. And during that time only, I realized that there were so many women, passionate women, doing some kind of businesses, having homegrown businesses or having some small startups, but they were really faltering back with technology. Like, if there's a lady who has, like, say, two kids, and even she's a fashion designer and she's, you know, selling clothes, she doesn't have a time of, say, 3 months or 4 months to go and attend a course on digital marketing, any big digital marketing institute. That's not possible for her. You know, so of course, for people like her, I thought that there needs to be some way out. So I decided that, you know, I will start from small and I will reach out to these women who are doing home-based businesses, who are having their own startups, and how I can help them because the things I had learned on my own startup, you know. And trust me, the doors keep opening for me. I met so many amazing women after that. And it's been a fantastic journey, as Sonali said that. I've trained over 6,000 people. And from that 6,000 people, if you ask me, 80% of my audience has been women. And I've been very happy to, you know, kind of do a little bit of contribution in their lives by making them digitally literate. Trust me, if someone like me who didn't have any knowledge about social media could do this and could reach this state, I feel everyone who's listening to me right now can also do that. Yes, so trust me. Social media as a platform has such an immense potential that just sitting at home, just using your smartphone, you can actually reach out to multitude people, you know. So that's what exactly you're going to be seeing today. Of course, we don't have the time to go in detail, but I'm going to throw light on some of the things that social media platforms, and for that matter, Instagram can do for you. And you could be doing anything. You could be probably selling clothes. You could be an amazing baker. You could also probably, you know, be an amazing speaker. You could just coordinate well, or you could communicate well, or, you know, you're an extrovert. Anything. You're a musician. You can sing well, or you're having your own business. Anything, you know, for you, there is a platform for you. There is an entire world where you can showcase your skill sets. So today, of course, I will be sharing some of my tips and tricks, which has really helped me, you know, get opportunity to be seen everywhere. And as I said, my biggest project was when I got to train around 1,000 doctors. And that entire big project I actually got through social media. CNBC, where I got interviewed, that project I got through social media. Recently, I got someone who said that we want you to take a session for our students in IIM Shillong. You know, so that they reached out to me on social media. So all my big projects have actually cracked through social media, and that's how immensely beneficial these platforms are. Yes, so today, of course, without spending a lot of time, I'm going to be straight away take you to the platform and seeing that where exactly can we go from here. So everyone, are you all excited for today's session? If you can tell me in the chat box. I want it to be a two-way conversation. Let's try and have interact with each other, and in whatever 1 hour, 1 hour, 15 minutes we are together, let's try and get how much ever we can from today's class. I'll try to make it as practical as possible so that you all can pick up real things from today's class and start incorporating it for your business. Yes, everyone with me? Is everyone with me?
Yes, we are.
Okay, wonderful. So we'll start with today's session on Instagram marketing and how this small platform can really take you to places. So I'm just going to quickly share my screen with you all. By the time, you can also follow me on Instagram. I'm Ami, a social media trainer. So my Instagram handle is Social Media Training Hub. And we kind of put up a lot of tips and tricks to grow on social media. So you can definitely connect with me on Instagram too. So this is my Instagram profile. Okay. Of course, there are a lot of other platforms, but today specifically, we'll talk about Instagram. Okay. Having said that, I don't want to start only with Instagram. I want you to understand Instagram is a platform. Where does it stand between the other platforms too? Say, for example, there's Facebook, there's Twitter, there's LinkedIn, there's YouTube. I mean, there are a plethora of platforms. Where does Instagram stand? You know, so I don't want you to study Instagram in isolation. So what I'm going to do is, in one line, what does each platform stands for and what is the purpose? Okay, so I'm going to say to you in one line about these platforms so that you're totally clear what is the purpose of each platform. Okay, so first, if we see, we have Facebook. Facebook as a platform is more community-driven platform. Okay, so you'll have a lot of conversations, you'll have a lot of discussions, you'll have a lot of communities. So you have women entrepreneurs community, you have a startup community, you have a teachers community, you have a mothers community, you have a teachers community or a trainers community, you have a fashion lover community or animal lover community, environment community. So like-minded people come together and they have formed communities on Facebook. Okay, so for that matter, if you actually see, Facebook is more a community based and community oriented platform. So if you really want to connect with like-minded people, you know, Facebook is a platform for you. For example, if I'm a woman and I'm an entrepreneur and I also stay in Powai in Mumbai, and say for example, I'm also a founder, so that way I'm a part of a Powai women community on Facebook, then I'm a part of startup community, I'm a part of women entrepreneurs community, I'm a part of youth community, I'm a part of founders community. So that way, and because I'm a trainer, so I'm also part of a trainers community. That way I have introduced myself in a lot of these Facebook communities, which in fact gets me a lot of networking opportunities, and through that I've also got some amazing clients. Yes, so Facebook as a platform is a more community-based platform. Vis-a-vis, if you see Instagram is a much more visual platform. Okay, so it's more about visual storytelling, about visual aesthetics. Okay, how your page is made, how do you put up your content, reels, and really visually appealing things. So it's all about good visuals with great content. Okay, so of course, we're going to see a little bit about what do I mean by great visuals and great content. Okay, so as I said, a visual storytelling is something that you can call Instagram for. Yes, a visual storytelling, selling concepts, selling ideas, weaving stories in a visually appealing manner is what Instagram is all about. Then of course, as we see Twitter. Twitter is like your microblog. So sharing your views and opinions about specific things, you know. So if there's a trending topic going on, what as a brand or as a founder, what do you feel about that? So sharing your thoughts, sharing your views, sharing your opinions, you know. So that way, Twitter can really help you to build a brand, build your own brand, have your own voice on social media. Yes. Vis-a-vis, if you see LinkedIn, I don't know how many of you all use, but trust me, it is a gold mine. If you haven't used LinkedIn, you are doing a grave mistake. I would suggest that all of you who are listening to me right now, immediately after the class, you should open a LinkedIn account. Okay, trust me, I have not spent even a penny on LinkedIn and it has given me some amazing business opportunities. Okay, so recently I got in touch with this guy who's from Dubai, and he runs, of course he's an NRI, but he runs an entire Indian community in Mumbai, in Dubai, and he wants me to do a LinkedIn workshop for them, you know. So because of being there and being active on LinkedIn, I started getting such global opportunities also. You know, so LinkedIn again is a gold mine. If you haven't explored it, you must be on it today. Yes, so LinkedIn, for that matter, is a platform to showcase your skill sets. For example, if I'm a trainer, as a trainer, what are my skill sets? What makes me different than other trainers? What is my USP? What is USP? My unique selling proposition. What is my uniqueness? What makes me different than the others? So that's what LinkedIn is for, you know, showcasing your skill sets. Then, of course, we have YouTube. YouTube is all kind of video content, video blogging, how to, why to, you know, everything related to videos is what YouTube is for. And then, of course, we have Pinterest. Pinterest is a platform for inspiration, you know, getting more and more ideas, getting more amazing inspiration ideas, and, you know, getting some amazing things. So Pinterest is for that. And then, of course, as I told you, so culmination of all these is what is called different social media platforms. So Facebook, as I said, is more community oriented platform. Instagram is much more visual storytelling. LinkedIn is much more for showcasing your skill sets. YouTube is all for your video content, your video blogging. Twitter is all, it's like a microblog to sharing your views and opinions. Yes, your thoughts about a particular trending topic. And then, of course, we have Pinterest is a platform for sharing or getting some amazing inspiration for your work, for your business, for your social media and all of that. Yes, so everyone, are you with me till here? If you can tell me in the chat box, social media platform in a very, very crisp manner. If you can tell me in the chat box, I think it would really be helpful if we try to make the session more interactive. Everyone, okay, super. So Nalini is saying yes. Can we have more people interacting with us on the chat box? Okay, wonderful. Thank you, Manjuri. Thanks, Gitika. Super. So what I'll also do is, as I told you, I'll try to make it more practical. So I'll show you some apps where you can make your own videos, you can make your own creators. If you want to add a logo to your photo, to your product, or if you want to remove a background from a picture. So, you know, I'll show you some of these hacks also, which will give you a lot of practical tips to take back after the class today. Yes. So now, having come to Instagram, as I said, Instagram is a visual storytelling. You have to see to it that your Instagram entire visual aesthetics are maintained very, very properly. Now, having come to Instagram, I'll quickly take you through some aspects of Instagram and what are these aspects. Okay. So as soon as you come to your Instagram, there are three kinds of profiles that you can create. Okay. So you can either create a professional profile, like a professional account. You can create a creator's account, or you can create a private account. Okay, so three kinds of accounts that you can create on Instagram: your private account, professional account, and creator's account. Okay, now what is the difference between the three? Now, a private account is actually for your personal use. So if you are not doing any business, or you just want to stay in touch with your friends and family, you want to just showcase your work or a hobby, or, you know, you want to use it very, very on a personal level, then you should have a private account on Instagram. Vis-a-vis, if you are a creator, for example, you're an influencer, you are a blogger, you kind of create content, you know, for that matter, you should create a creator's account. Okay. And then the third is a professional account. For example, if you're running business, you're selling something, you want to reach out to more and more people, you are selling a product or a service, you know, you have a local business. For that matter, you should definitely have a professional account. Okay. Now, what is the difference between the three? As I told you, the purpose of each of these three are different. Having said that, your professional and your creator's account has a lot of insights, like how your page is performing, how many likes did you get, how many followers did you get from this particular post, how much engagement did you get, what is your best performing post, what is the best time for you to post, from which city are more of your audience coming, you know, is it from Mumbai, is it from Delhi, is it from Chennai, is it from Calcutta, okay, even for the gender, do you have more male followers or female followers? So all these insights you don't get in a private account, you get it only in your professional account. Okay, so if you are really doing business, you should definitely have a professional account. But if you're using it for your personal use, you should always have a private account. Okay, having said that, I would also suggest and I would like to pinpoint that it's very important for you to maintain the security of your accounts. Okay, today, these days, a lot of accounts are getting hacked. Even people's WhatsApp are getting hacked. Okay, so there's one small thing I would like all of you all to do is to activate two-factor authentication on your social media platforms. Now, what is that? So if I actually go on the top side on these three lines, when I go to these three lines, I get this option called settings. As soon as I go to settings, okay, I get privacy settings. Okay, so of course, from here, you can actually make, I can make my account a private account, but I don't want to make it a private account right now. So you go to your settings, okay, then you go to your security from here, and there's this option called the fourth option, two-factor authentication. When you click there, you can actually, you know, create or accept this. So what will happen is whenever someone is trying to log into your account, even if they have your password, they have your ID, and if they're trying to log in from some other account, okay, if they're trying to log in from some other account, then you will get a notification. Only if you accept will they allow that person to log in. Okay, so for that matter, two-factor authentication is an absolute must. You must definitely activate this. This feature is even there on your WhatsApp, your LinkedIn, your Facebook, everywhere. So just go to your security settings and please activate your two-factor authentication even on your WhatsApp. It will really help your account to not get hacked by anyone. Okay, so having said that, so we have three kinds of profiles, and after having said that, you need to have a two-factor authentication activated so that your account is not, you know, compromised in any manner. Okay, now when we come to our Instagram, I'll show you some different things that that the Instagram profile has and what is it used for. I mean, each and every feature and what is that feature used for. Okay, now if you see here on the top is my profile picture. Okay, so if you see, I put up my own picture with a solid color background behind my picture. Now, what happens is when people are scrolling through Instagram, there are so many accounts. Everyone is posting something or the other. So your profile can get lost between so many accounts. Okay, so for that matter, you can actually create a picture like this where you have your own picture with a solid color background that will help people to recognize you faster from other 1,000 profiles. Okay, I will also show you how do you quickly do it. It's very easy and it's a lot of fun. You can actually remove a background from a picture and you can add your own background. Okay, so I would always suggest on your profile picture, you should always have a solid color background behind your personal picture. If it is a personal picture that you've used, you can use that. This way it will help you to connect with your audience in a better way. Now, how do you do that? So I'm just going to go. So I'm going to show you some hacks and tips as soon as I go ahead. So I'm going to go to this platform. You can also write it down. The name of this platform is called RemoveBG. R-E-M-O-V-E, RemoveBG, okay? So what I can do is, it's like a magic platform. I just have to go and upload an image. So I'm just going to pick up an image, say from my gallery. So I'm just going to pick up. Let me just pick up any one picture from my images. See, I'm picking up, say this picture, okay? I picked up a picture, this is the original picture. And if you see, once I remove the background, this was the original one, and the background has been removed in like few seconds. Okay, so you can actually remove a background from any picture that you want, and you can add your own background. Now, if I want to add a background, there is this edit option on the top. When I click on edit, I get a lot of these options where I can actually add different backgrounds to this picture. Can you see this? I can also add solid colors to this background. Can you just see here? That's it. I just have to download this from the top and then I can just go to my Instagram and just upload this. By the way, this hack, you can do it for anything. If you have a product and you want to remove a background and put your own background, you can actually go to RemoveBG, remove the background and put up your own background that you want. Yes, everyone? Interesting, easy, nice, simple. So remove BG will help you to remove a background from a picture. Yes, everyone with me? Okay. Very nice, simple and easy. Okay. So I'm going to come out of this now. Going back to my Instagram. So if you see here, this is how I've created my profile picture. I've removed the background and then I've kind of have added a solid color background behind my picture. So it helps people to recognize me faster. Okay. Then if you see here, I've put up my entire about section. So where you, this is where you see Ami social media trainer and consultant, trained 6,000 plus. So that is my bio section, my bio, you know, a small detail about who I am and what I do. So it's very important that you fill in that information. So you can go to edit profile over here, okay, and fill in all the information over here. Exactly what is your company about, who you are, what do you do, what is it that you are selling, what are the kind of things you sell. You know, so you can actually put up, so if you're a baker, so say we bake customized cakes for your birthdays, weddings, events, personalized events. Or for example, you're a fashion designer, we are an ethnic boutique store, stitching customized clothes for your wedding needs. Or, you know, so try to make it as simple as possible, but see to it that all the necessary information are kind of provided over here. Okay, so please put up all this information over there. Yeah, so that will be your bio section. Your bio will have all the information about you and your company. Okay, so you start with your profile picture. Then you have your entire bio section. Then when you come down, we have a lot of these sections. So if you see, these are my highlights. Okay, now what are these highlights? So you all would have known about Instagram stories, you know, which are there only for 24 hours. But after 24 hours, if I still want to show it, I can put them in my highlights. Now, what could highlights be? Highlights could be different parts about your business. So you can have different services. Say, for example, I'm a jewelry designer. So my one highlight could be earrings. My another highlight could be bangles. My third highlight could be necklaces. My fourth highlight could be client testimonials. And when people click on it, they can actually see 10 earrings, 10 bangles, different products and different services that I offer. So you can actually bifurcate each and every highlight with a particular product or service. Okay, so that is what highlights will be important for you. Now, when you come down, there are these five sections on your Instagram profile, okay? So very quickly, I'm going to take you through what are these different sections and how you can use them, okay? So your first section is your Instagram feed, okay? If all of y'all can also just quickly follow me, you can also just have a look at my page so I can actually tell you what exactly you can do. Okay, so this, if you see, this is my feed, F-E-E-D, it's called feed, okay? The first section is called feed. So all my day-to-day postings will all come here. Okay, so any informational content, anything about my products that I want to tell people, my day-to-day posting will all come in my feed. Okay, so this is my day-to-day posting section. After that, if you go, there is a section called reels. These days, everyone is putting up reels and they're putting up videos. Now, what are reels? Okay, so reels are nothing but 30-second vertical videos to show things about, you know, about your business or fun content, educational content in a fun way. Okay, so if you would have seen, so many people are putting some amazing reels, transition reels, and a lot of things they are putting up. So, you know, these are some kind of reels that you can actually make, and maximum 30-second vertical videos. Okay, after that, you have something called IGTV. Now, what is IGTV? IGTV are videos again, but these are more than 1 minute videos. Reels were 30 seconds. IGTV will be more than 1 minute. You know, it can also have your Instagram live. So if you've gone live with someone, you can actually put it up on your IGTV. So IGTV will be your video content, educational video content, which is more than 1 minute. Okay. After that, there's this new feature. It is called Instagram Guides. What is Instagram Guides? So say, for example, on my entire page, okay, so if you see, I put up a lot of educational content, fun content and everything. But say for example, all my posts would be, you know, they would be here and there. Like we do a lot of giveaways on our Instagram page. If you see, we do a lot of giveaways. So if I want to kind of have one guide where my followers can see all my giveaways together, they can see all my giveaways together. So I can actually create a guide for it. Say for example, if you would be seeing on my page, we had recently done a giveaway on Mother's Day. Then we had done on Friendships Day. So this was our Mother's Day giveaway, okay, which we had done. We had over 600 people who had engaged with our dad post. Then we had done one giveaway for Women's Day. Then we'd also done a giveaway when we had reached 10,000 followers. So we reached 10,000 followers this year. So we'd also done a giveaway during that time. So this was our 10,000 followers giveaway. So like that, if you see, we've done different giveaways on our page. But if I want my people to see all my giveaways together, I can actually make a guide for it. Okay. So if you see here, giveaways and collabs. So if you see, they'll be able to see all my giveaways together at one place. Okay. So basically clubbing your similar category post into one category and making it into a guide. So that is what Instagram will, this feature of Instagram will help you. Clubbing similar category of posts into one guide. Okay, so these are all your guides. And if people want to see my my Mother's Day giveaway, they just have to click here and they'll automatically go to my that post. Okay, so that is your section of guides. And then the last section, if you see, this is a section where everywhere you have been tagged, if someone has tagged you on their post or anything of that sort, then all these posts will come here. Like for example, Kove had made this amazing creative and they had tagged me. So wherever I'm getting tagged, all these will come in this section, which is my tagged section. Okay. So very, very quickly, this is your Instagram feed. The first one is called your feed, your day-to-day posting. Everything that you do day on a day-to-day is you want to show your people about your products, about you want to give them some knowledge, some education material, all of this you can do it over here. Then is your 30-second reels, okay, which is more fun content related to your business, which are vertical 30-second videos with trending music. Then you have your IGTV, which are more than 1 minute videos which are more than 1 minute, more educational type of a content. Then you have your guides. Now, what are guides? Similar posts. If you want to club them together into one category, you can create multiple guides. So, for example, we also do social media tips for different professionals. So, if you see here, we've done social media tips for doctors, for authors, for makeup artists, for image consultants. So, I have clubbed them all together in one guide. So say for example, if there is a doctor and he wants to see social media tips for doctors, you just have to click here and he'll actually come to my this post. Okay, so that way I can create different guides for different things. And then the last section is of course your posts where you have been tagged. Everywhere where you have been tagged, all the posts are going to show up over here. These are your highlights. So if I want to convert my story, because story is only for 24 hours. After 24 hours, I still want people to see that, I can put them in a highlight. Basically, highlights will help you to bifurcate your different products and services into categories. So say for example, if I'm a baker, so I can have one category as wedding cakes, one category as customized cakes, one category as cupcakes, one category as muffins, one category as croissants. So like that, I can create different categories and I can create highlights for that. Okay. Then of course is your, if you go above, there is this bio section. It will talk more about who you are as a company and what do you do. And of course your profile picture on the top with a solid color background behind your picture. Okay, of course I can take a session for each category in detail. I need minimum 2 hours for each category, but right now in whatever time we have, I'll try and show you, you know, different things of how basically Instagram can help you to reach out to your audience. And trust me, it is so easy and it is so amazing. Everyone with me, did you all understand different features of Instagram and how it can help you? If you can tell me in the chat box. Okay, superb, superb. Now, what I'm also going to do is I'm going to show you some hacks and tips and tricks, and also show you some apps which can really make your life very, very easy. Okay, so I don't know how many of you all know, but there's this amazing app called Canva. How many of you all use Canva? If you can tell me in the chat box. How many of you all use Canva? Canva. Okay, Gitika, Preeti. Wonderful, wonderful. So many of you all are actually using Canva. But for people who don't know, probably for them, and also for the people who already use, but there are a lot of hacks which you might not be knowing, which you can actually do on Canva. Okay, so people who are not using, so Canva is an amazing tool to make your digital creatives. Okay, so if you want to put up a social media post and you don't know what to make, you can just go to Canva. They have some amazing templates over there. You just go to those templates, okay? Select the template that you want. Say, for example, I want this template. I want to put up my product picture over here. So I can actually go here, okay? I can just remove this picture. I can also add my own picture over here, okay? So I just have to go to this plus sign. I am just taking a picture. Right now, just I'm taking a random picture right now. And I can actually put up a picture over here. Can you just see here? So like that, I can put up my own product pictures. I can write if I want to write something. I can also write there. I can put up my logo. I can put up frames. There are tons and tons of things that I can do on Canva. Yeah. So if I want to write something, I can just click on the plus sign over here. Put up the text option. I get some amazing text options over here. So I can select any one text option that I want. Yeah. And then I can just maybe put it down here, and just I can say write Ami Himani. Okay. I can change the color also if I want of this. I can change this color to whichever color I want. I can change it to that color. Okay. If I want, I can add my own picture also, by the way, over here. I can just move this over here from here to here. So you can actually create a lot of things using Canva. You can make your own creatives. Okay. Now I want to show you something. These are existing creatives, but what are different things that you can do? Okay. So I'm going to just delete all of this right now. And I'm going to show you some things that you can actually do on Canva in like, say, 5 minutes, so that, you know, things become very, very easy for you. So I'm just deleting all of this. So this becomes my plain template. Now there are a lot of amazing things that you can do. So I can actually go to this plus sign, okay? And I can go to this elements over here, and I can do a lot of things. For example, I want to give like a border to this template. So I can just go and look out for this square border, and I can actually give like a border to this square. Can you see this? I can actually give a border to this square. Now, if I want to kind of introduce the founder of this company, I want to write something. So I can actually go to this plus sign, okay, over here. And then I'm going to look out for, okay, I'm going to look out for frames, okay? And I am going to look out for, say, or I want to show my website. Okay, my new website has come and I want to showcase that website. So I can actually click this, which is a desktop version. Okay. And then I can put up a picture of my website over here. So just go to this plus sign. Okay. I'm right now just selecting any photo. This is just for you to see. I'm just looking for a picture of any random picture I'm looking out for right now. So say I've got this picture. So say, for example, if this is my website picture, so I can just put this over here. And can you see this? I can show this as my website, and I can write niche website ka details. So I just have to go to text option over here, write a subheading, and I can just write in www.flower.com. Can you see here? And I can just put this over here. So like that, you can do tons and tons of things on Canva. If you see, I put up a square color border to it. I put up a desktop picture, a desktop frame, and I put up a picture in it. So there are some amazing things that you can actually do on Canva, by the way. Okay, I'll show you some more things. Say, for example, if I've just reached, say, 10,000 followers, or if you've reached 500 or 1,000 followers, so what you can do is you can again go over here. Okay, go to Elements. Again, look out for frames. And now I'm going to look out for different frames. Okay, so I'm going to go to frames. Because I've reached 10,000 followers, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick up the number one. Okay, I'm going to just pick this up here. These are some hacks that I'm just showing you that you can actually do. I'm going to now put up zero. I'm going to put up 10K. Okay, so I just want to put up 10K, so I'm just going to put up K over here. Okay, so I'm just picking up K from here. Okay, so 10K followers if I want to show my people. So I just can do this over here. Now just see what I'm going to do. I'm going to again go to Elements. Okay, and here I'm going to look out for golden. Just look out for golden so that you can give like a festive feel to it. I'm just picking up any one gold and I'm just going to put it to this one here. Can you see what did I do? Like that, I can actually give gold to zero. I can have a gold to K, and I can actually create like a festive thing about 10K followers. You know, so these are some super duper things that you can actually do on Canva with your elements. So if you actually go to your elements section, there are tons and tons of things you can add backgrounds, you can add your audio, you can add different graphics, lines, shapes, videos, some charts to show, grids to show, collages, like tons and tons that you can do it on Canva. So people who haven't used, please reuse it. People who have used, please, again, for you to just go and see the immense kind of possibilities that Canva has for you. Okay. Having said that, we come back to our Instagram. Okay. So as I was telling you, there are different things that you can actually do on your Instagram. Now, I'm also going to show you some things that you can do even on your Instagram stories. Okay. So I'm going to show you some really cool things. Like, say, for example, you want to make an Instagram story, but you kind of don't know how to make a nice background, or you want to put up something really nice. So I'm going to show you some story hacks, like very quickly some story hacks. So I'm just going to go to this plus sign, go to this story. Okay. And then what I'm going to do is, if you can see Niche, there are a lot of these filter options. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and check out these filter options, and I'm going to go and look out for more filter options. Over here, I'm going to search for a keyword called background N1. Background N1. As soon as I click on background N1, can you see Instagram has given me so many backgrounds for Instagram, for my Instagram stories. I can pick up whichever background I want. I can click on try it. And then I can write down whatever I want to write over here. I can add a picture over here. So I can actually write down whatever I want to write. I'm going to add a picture. So if you see on the top, there's a square smiley. I can click on the square smiley. And I'm going to pick up any one picture. So, for example, I want to put up this picture over here, which I just made. I can actually put up a picture. And just see what I'm going to do. As soon as I click on this picture, it's going to change shapes. Can you see? I can give a different shapes to this picture. And I can make it something really nice and fun. Okay. So in case you want to put up a product on your Instagram story, but you don't know, you don't have good backgrounds, you can actually go to your Instagram filters, look out for a keyword called background N1. It's going to give you some amazing filters, some amazing background options, which you can use it for your Instagram stories. So like that, if you also search for background N2, you'll get more options. Similarly, if you're looking out for background N3, they'll give you some more options. Can you see this? You can pick up any one option that you want, put up your product picture there, write something over there, and put it up as your Instagram story. Yes, everyone. Interesting, nice, easy, fun. Of course, because we don't have a lot of time, so I might not be able to go in detail, but this is, guys, I'm telling you, it's just a tip of an iceberg. And as I said, please keep following us on Instagram, because every day we keep sharing such new hacks and ideas. Yes, so Instagram is such an amazing world. I'll tell you, I'm showing you all of this is because, say, for example, if you have your own business and you want to now maybe even earn part-time money, you can actually use these skills which are inside Instagram. I have so many women who've done workshops with me, and now they've started business out of it. They are doing businesses like, we'll make 10 creatives for you, we'll make 10 Instagram stories for you for so much, we'll make amazing creatives on Canva for you, and they're charging money, and people and brands are ready to pay them. So even while learning all of these things, you can do some amazing business out of it, so you can earn money, or it will help you also to promote your business in a fun way. Yes, so these are some things that I wanted to show you. Okay, now you can also look out for this option called, another keyword called mockup. So if you just search for this keyword called mockup, again, some amazing things that come up. You get these options where you can actually put up your own picture. So for example, this is a tablet, and I want to add a picture to this. I can actually add a 15-second video or even a photograph. So I'm going to click on try it. I'm going to click on add media, and I can actually put up a picture like this. Can you see here? I can actually add a picture like this. Like, say, for example, Kove had put up this workshop thing about me. So I can actually put this up over here. You don't need to make anything on Canva, nothing. Everything is readily available. Just put your picture there. Okay, just go put your picture there, and you are able to make some amazing creatives on Instagram by just one click. Yes, everyone, with me. Interesting, easy, fun. So this is an option which I was telling you. It's called mock-up option. So you've put up a new post on your Instagram, okay, and you want to put that up also. So you can just select this one. Click on try it again. Add a media, and I can actually put up my new post like this. Can you see here how I put up? Everything is ready. My background is ready. I just have to add a picture. Sure, Preeti, I'll tell you how do you do this. So you just, when you are searching for your Instagram stories, there are these filters. So if you see this, in this filters, you go to this last option and you search over here for a new effect. Yes, it's in the filters option. Yes, guys, easy, fun. Okay, I'm going to show you something really nice. Okay, now, if you would have seen the movie Bahubali, I'm sure everyone would have, and this concept is so this, that the green screen effect, if you would have seen, how people put green screen to create some amazing things out there, like people, with green screen, you can show people flying, and you would have seen the entire Bahubali, that movie was made. After that, the green screen effect was very famous. How many of you all know about green screen effect? If you can tell me in the chat box. And you would have seen a lot of movies with where people are using green screens to do some amazing things. Okay, Nisha is saying she knows about green screen. What about others? Do you all know about green screen effect? Like if you see this very, very action-oriented movies, you feel that, oh, they are jumping from a mountain. But actually, they are not. They are using green screen to make all of this. Okay, so even on Instagram, of course, not Bahubali types, but you can do some really cool things. Okay, so I'm going to select this filter called green screen. Okay, so there's this filter called green screen effect. Now, what I can do is I can actually showcase to people that I'm at some place. Okay, so what I can do is I can add a media over here. Okay. I'm just going to show you. Say, for example, I want to show people that I'm in Ladakh right now. So I'm just going to take a picture of my earlier Ladakh trip, actually, where I was like 3 years ago. So this is my Ladakh trip picture. okay. Just let me just try it again. It's not happening. Just go here. Go to your stories. Select green screen. Okay. Add a picture. Okay, so I don't know, there's some technical glitch, but what happens is, so I can actually have like a background behind and I can actually point it out over here and I can say green screen, okay, and I can add a media and it'll, the entire Ladakh photo is going to come behind me and I can showcase whatever I want to showcase and it's going to help me create that green screen effect, okay. So I think there's some technical error, it's not happening right now, but this is how you can actually use green screen effect. Okay, so you just go to your filters option over here, just go to your story over here. If you can't find, just go to the very end of it and then search for green screen by Instagram. Okay, so just search for green screen effect. Okay, and Instagram is going to give you green screen. You can just click on try it. Okay. Again, as I said, just add a media to it. Okay, can you just see here? I've just done it. I've added a media and I've added a picture and I can just showcase things behind me. Okay. I can select the picture that I want and I can add a media and I can show things over here, there. Okay. And I can actually take a picture. Let me just show that. Okay, see, I can actually take a picture of me in Ladakh and I can write down things over here also if I want. Yes, everyone, did you all get it? How did I do it? So this is called your green screen effect and you can superimpose any picture or a video behind you and you can show things around. So if I want to show my screen, say for example, yesterday Andy, I taught this. I can, if I've reached say 11,000 followers, so I can actually take a screenshot of that and tell people about it. So I just go to screenshots. Okay. And I'll take a picture of me with 10,000 followers. Just take a screenshot of your profile. So for example, I'm just taking a screenshot of my profile and I'm just showcasing things around. Can you see this? And this is how I can show green screen effect. Everyone with me, interesting, nice, fun, easy. Okay, now I'll show you some more things. I'm going to show you just one more hack that you can actually do. So I'm just going to go to story again. I'm going to click on create story. Okay. Now just see what I'm going to do. Okay. So, I can actually do some amazing things inside Instagram stories itself. And trust me, you can do so, you can create like magic on your Instagram with these things. Okay. So say I'm just going to add a picture from my Instagram over here. I've just added this picture. Okay. I can give like a lot of letters, different kind of letters. If I want to give like a, say a block letter, I can actually create like block letters, say Ami. Okay, so this is what I've created, a different kind of font. It's called block letter fonts. Okay, now just to make a little variation to this, I can make these letters as hanging letters. What can I do? I just have to click on AA on the top. Simple. Okay, from my screen. Okay, from my keyboard, there's this underscore sign. You would have seen amisavla@_23@gmail.com. So the underscore sign, I'll keep clicking on that underscore sign if you see on the keyboard. And I'm going to just remove the highlight from here. Now this line, I'm just going to straighten it. Okay, I'm going to just straighten this line and I'm going to make this as a hanging letter. Guys, did you see what did I do? I just made it like a straight line. I made this as a hanging letter. Just go to your keyboard. Just click on underscore, underscore, underscore to make it a line. Okay. And this line, I can just straighten it. And just making like a hanging letter. So you can make block letters and then you can make like, say, hanging letters like this. Yes, guys. Interesting, nice, fun, easy. Okay, so these are different kind of things that you can actually do on your Instagram stories and make it look really nice, fun and authentic. Okay, what you can also do is say this is a purple color, but I want different colors. Like say I want 3 colors behind the background. So what I'll do is I click on AA, then I'll click on full stop in my keyboard and I'm going to just give it a highlight. Just keep pressing spacebar, spacebar, spacebar to give like a big line. Okay. And I'm going to just change this color to say yellow color or orange color maybe. What I'm going to do is I'm going to just with my finger make it like really big and I can actually make something like this, like a 2 color thing. Yes, guys. So I made like 2 colors just with my keyboard. I can make 1 more color. Just go to AA again, full stop, highlight it, keep highlighting it. Okay. Say I'm going to change this color to maybe baby pink color again, just with my, oh, sorry, I deleted it by mistake. Just give this color as a baby pink color with my finger. I'm just going to make it big. Okay. Can you just see here? I've made like 3 color background behind. Like that, I can add, keep adding different colors to this and make like an amazing Instagram story out of this. I can add more pictures. For example, this picture only, I want to show it in different formats. So one is a circle format. Now I'm going and adding a picture again. This is in a square format. Now I'm adding a picture again. This is in a heart format. Yes, guys. Fun, easy. There's so many things you can actually do it on your Instagram stories. And this way, you can sell your products in a better way. Instead of just putting up your products on your stories, if you do these things, people are going to get more engaged with your Instagram stories. And you can do really fun things on your Instagram. Yes, everyone. And this again, I haven't used any other app. I'm using everything inside Instagram itself. Everyone with me in the chat box. Are you all getting it? What exactly I'm trying to tell you? And how you all can make your Instagram lot of fun, interesting, nice, super easy. Again, as I said, guys, this is just a tip of iceberg. I need like minimum 2 hours to cover only Instagram stories, 2 hours only for reels, 2 hours only for feed, 2 hours only for bio. But right now we don't have so much time. But in limited time, whatever I can teach you or whatever I feel is important will help you. I'm showing you all of those things. Okay, so these are some different things that you can actually do. Now I'm going to show you one more hack. Okay, say for example, I've done a new post and I want people to see that post. Okay, say for example, I've done this post, the second one, and I want people to see. What I'm going to do is, or I'm just going to take a screenshot of this. Okay, so I've just taken a screenshot of my entire screen. I'm taking that screenshot onto my story. So I'm just taking that screenshot over here. Now just see what I'm going to do, okay? So I want people to highlight on a particular thing. I want to show people that I've reached 10,000 followers. So see what I'm going to do is, I'm going to go to this twisted line on the top, okay? Take this pink color maybe, and just long press on the screen. So the entire thing is going to go pink. Then I'm going to take an eraser, and I'm going to start erasing over here. Can you see here? So say for example, I just want to show only this much part, or I want to show only my first post. So I can actually show there and tell people to go there and see it. okay? Or for example, that matter, I want to just show my first post and I want people to come and see my first post. So what I can do is, wait, I'll just take a picture of my first, say for example, I'll take a picture of my feed, but I want people to see that particular post, okay? So I'm just going to go to my Instagram stories. Okay, with this twisted line, I'm going to just hide this entire thing. With my eraser, I'm just going to erase the first, this post. I want people to see this post. Okay. And then what I can do is, I can just write over here, go to this square smiley, look out for this GIF called new post. Okay, it's going to give me a lot of new post ideas. So I'm just going to pick up any one, like this over here. And then make an arrow like this over here. Can you see here, guys? What did I do? And then you just put it up. So this will just make people, you know, curious to go and check out your new post. That Manjari, as soon as you put up new post, the post is going to go down. So Manjari, you cannot do anything about that. Yes, these are some hacks and tips and tricks which will make you, help you to make some really cool creatives on your Instagram stories, guys. Okay, Preeti, if you see, there is this twisted line on the top. There is this double A on the extreme right, and next to it, there's this twisted line. As soon as I click on twisted line, I get a lot of these options. Okay. By the way, if you see, I put up a solid color behind. I can actually put up a little lighter color also. So let me just show you another hack. So what I can actually do is, I'll click on the twisted line again. Okay, pick up another color. So I'm picking up a yellow color. And I'm going to pick up the third pen from the top. From the left hand side, the third pen. I'm clicking on that. And then I'm going to long press on the screen. Can you just see here? So it's not gone solid, but little bit is seen. Again, I'll take an eraser and erase the one that I want. And I can do a new post over here too. Yes, everyone. Interesting, fun, easy. How many of you all are already trying things as I'm saying, and all are really putting it up? So exactly, Nisha. So for me, if I have to teach you full Instagram, I need minimum 6 days. But if I have to just take, like, say 1 hour, 15 minutes, then, you know, I want to make it more interactive and practical so that y'all can actually use these things. Exactly. So these are some interesting story tips, but of course we have a lot of feed tips, like what are the kind of things you can do on your Instagram feed to get more followers, to get more engagement, to get more people. But okay, so there are a lot of things, like I'll show you one hack. Like, say for example, if I have done a reel, okay, I've done this reel and I want more and more people. So like right now we have around 7,600 views to that reel. I want more views to this reel. So what I can actually do is, I just have to click on this reel. Okay. Add this reel to my story. So I can actually add this reel to the story. Now just see what I'm going to do. Okay. What I'm going to do is, this is just a hack. I'm going to make this very, very small. I'm going to make this very, very small. And I'm going to superimpose this reel with a picture. So I'm going to just add a picture to this. No one will come to know. Okay. So I'll add, say, two pictures to this. Okay, so I'm adding this picture, one. And I'm adding one more picture. This is an example, of course. And I'm adding one, this picture. So I can actually do this like this over here. And then I can put up an option or a poll option. Square or circle. just try and make it more interactive, okay, and just put this over here like this. So what will happen is anyone who checks your stories, they'll check your stories, but they'll never come to know that you've actually put up a reel behind that story. And when anyone waits on your story for minimum five seconds, your reel views are going to increase. And once your reel views increase, your page engagement is going to increase. Once your page engagement increases, more and more people are going to come visit your page. Yes, everyone. So if you actually see, I've put up a reel behind this, but no one will ever come to know that I've actually put up a reel. So I've superimposed a picture with a reel. The reel with a picture. Okay, so these are some hacks that you can actually do to increase your visibility, increase your things about Instagram and reach out to like tons and tons of people. Okay, so these are some hacks that you should definitely use. Okay. Also, there is one more hack that I would like to tell you all that you all should definitely use. Say, for example, if I have put up a carousel image of, say, 7 pictures, okay? So there is one feature on Instagram which many of us don't know, which we should definitely use, which will increase the SEO of our page. Means organically, Instagram is going to show our page to more and more people with this feature. Now, how do you do this? So you click on these three dots on the top, and you click on edit image. As soon as you click on edit image, you get this option on the bottom right hand side called edit all text. You can actually give a title to each and every post of this. Okay, so what will happen is people will not be able to see this. Of course, they cannot see your individual titles, but this is going to help you in your SEO. Now, what is alt text? Alt text is a feature which Instagram has given so that people who are visually, they are not fine. I mean, they are visually impaired, people who cannot see properly. For them, they'll be able to interact with this post of yours because of this feature called alt text. Okay, because of this feature called alt text, people who are visually impaired, who cannot see properly, they'll be able to interact with your post. So what happens is when you use alt text, Instagram feels that you are providing value to even that community. And that way, because of their algorithm, when you use this feature, it's going to push your post to more and more people. Okay, there are a lot of people who don't know about this, but when you use alt text, Instagram is going to push your post to more and more people. So more and more people can engage with your post. Okay, so this is an alt text feature which you can use. You can also use this for your new post. So when I'm putting up a new post, okay, so for example, I'm putting up this picture of mine, taking next, when I write a caption over here, along with caption, I can go niche. Last, if you see, there's this advanced settings. As soon as I go to advanced settings, there is this option called write all text. Below accessibility, there is something called write all text. I just have to go here and I can write an alt text over here, which will help, as I said, visually impaired people from across the globe to interact with my post. And because I have used this feature, Instagram is going to promote me and engage with my post more. Yes, everyone. So like that, of course, there are tons of hacks. So I don't want to like bombard you all with too much of information and confuse you. But these are some highlights that you should definitely use on your Instagram to get more and more people engaged with your page. Yes, everyone, with me, interesting, fun, nice, simple, easy.
So now we can take some questions.
Yes, let's take some questions.
So there's Manjuri asking you tips to ensure how it reaches maximum people and the right audience.
Okay, so Manjuri, as I said, of course, first, any tips to increase followers, okay? So as I said, I need minimum 6 days to cover everything. But if you have to see visual aesthetics, the way that your page is entire made, so the grid of your page. Say, for example, if I'm just going to this page called Water, okay? So there's this amazing NGO called Water. So if you actually see their entire feed, it is like a properly planned feed. They have used just their brand colors, you know? Just see how they have put up the pictures. Or I'll show you another page called Preview. This is another great page. If you see the way they have put up, can you just see her? So they put up like one entire row is pink color, then is a sea green color, then is a cream color. So this is how, if you pre-plan your feed in a nice, effective manner, more and more people, so in our experience, we've seen the more beautiful your grid is and the more value-based content you put on your page, more people are going to come to your page. Okay, so first of all, as I said, work on all these things. Okay, one, work on your bio. Your bio, people don't realize, but you know, of course. So if you just go to your bio, people, you don't realize, but through your bio, so many new people can come to your page. Okay, so see to it that your bio is updated. The name of your page is with keywords. Don't use random things on your name. Use proper keywords so that it can really help you. Of course, there is a 5-point entire hashtag strategy which you need to use, which I'll not be able to cover right now. It's like an entire big topic. So today I just had to show you the kind of immense potential Instagram has, but maybe if we want like a proper session, we can plan and, you know, I can teach you each and everything in detail. So there's a 5-point hashtag strategy, which if you use, you can actually get people from who are not even following you. They can start following you on Instagram. Okay, there is an entire 4-point caption strategy. What kind of captions to use? How do you use that? So having right captions, having right hashtags, having right picture with right things on it, using different hacks. Like I told you, alt text. I told you how to, put up a reel on your story. Like that, we have 20, 30 more hacks, which you can actually do to get more followers on your page. Okay, then of course, we use a lot of reels. So if you use more reels organically, your page is going to get pushed to more and more people. Yes, then if you use more guides, that way also Instagram is going to push you. So the more new features that Instagram gets, the more you use them, the more it's going to help you to reach out to more and more people. Yes, having said that, Instagram stories is an amazing way to engage with your current audience. You know, also if you want to connect with similar like-minded kind of people and you want, so I'll show you one more last hack. So I'm just going to share my screen actually from my laptop now. So there was one question, if similar pages say you want followers, so how do you do that? But that also, there are a lot of ways, but I'll just show you one such way. So what you do is, you go to your Instagram from your laptop or your desktop, okay? You go to your profile. As soon as you go to your profile, there is this edit profile option. So you go to your edit profile option, you go ekdam niche. If you go at the niche, there is this option called include your account when recommending similar accounts people might want to follow. So just click on tick mark. So what will happen is, if example, you're a fashion designer and someone has checked a fashion designer's page. As soon as that person follows that page, Instagram is going to show your page too. Okay, so this is how similar recommendations is going to help. So this is only available on your desktop, laptop version. Just go to www.instagram.com on your laptop, desktop. Okay, and just put this up, just tick mark this and you'll be able to do it. Okay, having said that, as I said, there are tons and tons of things, how the visual aesthetics, how your creative should be, how your reel should be, the size of your reel, how much content should be there on your reel, how much content should be there on your picture, what kind of content should be there, you know, so there needs to be a strategy for each and every thing. And if you do all of that, trust me, building followers on Instagram is, I'm not saying it is easy, but if you do the things regularly, you will start getting sustained followers from your Instagram. Yes, Sonali, are there any questions that I have missed? Of course, guys, you guys are very excited to know a lot of information, but, you know, giving in this time frame, I might not be able to cover everything, but, you know, just again, as I said, connect with me on Instagram. There are a lot of hacks and tips and tricks, which we've already shared for the questions that you guys have asked. You can also ask me on my personal chat on Instagram. I'll be more than happy to help you. 100% hashtags 100% helps you. There's a 30 hashtags maximum that you can use in your post. And if you use a 5-point hashtag strategy that we've built, you can really reach out to more and more people to this. When a brand is eligible to enable ad shop buttons, so to be very honest, Nisha, I think it's Nisha, right now, not all the countries in the world have this option right now. Only some Indian users right now has that option. Okay, so for that, you need a shop section even on your Facebook page. Once you have that, you'll be able to enable. So there is a form which you need to fill. If Instagram feed that you are eligible, they'll give it to you. But as I said, right now, it is still in the testing phase. Not all Indian users have an ad shop section. Gradually, you will get it. But for that, you have to fill up a form. If Instagram is okay with that, only then you get in that option. Not really, Manjari. Amazon and Insta is not linked. No. But you can actually add your Shopify with your Facebook page account and you can able to do that. How to add swipe up feature in your Instagram story, Shivangi? Right now, it is only available for people who have minimum 10,000 followers. If you don't have 10,000 followers, you cannot use the regular swipe up, but you can still use it. How I'll show you how do you use it. So you just go, I'm just going to share my screen with you all. I can still use a swipe up if I don't have 10,000 followers, but only for my IGTV videos. So say for example, there's this IGTV video about this, learn about marketing storytelling, and I want to use a swipe up option. So I just have to go to my story. So for example, I'm just right now picking up any picture. Okay, I can actually go, if you see on the top, there is a pin sign. Okay, I just have to click on that pin sign and I get two options, swipe up web link and swipe up IGTV video. I'm getting web link is because I have 10,000 followers. If you don't have 10,000 followers, you're not going to get that option. You will only get an option called IGTV video. I'm going to click on IGTV video. I'm going to pick up any one video. So I want this video for people to see. I'm going to click that. And then I'm going to add a GIF called swipe up. So as soon as I click on the swipe up option over here, people can check my stories, they can swipe up and they'll be able to go to my that IGTV video. As I said, you have swipe up only for IGTV video if you have less than 10,000 followers. Once you have more than 10,000 followers, you'll be able to use a regular swipe up option. Yes, everyone.
Yes, I think we have more questions in the chat box.
Okay. If there are any questions that I may have missed, Sonali, if you can, just read it out.
Do you have more questions?
Everyone wants to know how to increase followers. As I said, guys, for that, please just follow us on Instagram, Social Media Training Hub. We have some amazing workshops coming up. Like next week, we have a full 2 days Reels workshop coming up. After that, we're going to do like a 6-day Instagram masterclass. We're going to teach you everything in detail. So y'all can, kind of attend those workshops and get to learn a lot of things. Of course, today was just the tip of the iceberg. Tons and tons of more things that can be shown to you.
Hi, Ami.
Yes.
This is Vandana.
Hi, Vandana.
Okay. Just wanted to know if we need to do more of these workshops for Kove. I think they're brilliant. And we need to do a more in-depth, a session.
Uh-huh.
So this, like you are saying, it's tip of the iceberg. So yes, we need to know the iceberg totally.
Correct.
Yeah. So Shilpi will probably keep in touch with you and let's see how we can take it forward further.
100%.
Okay. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Shilpi, you are there?
Yes, I'm there.
Hi.
Hi.
Do we have any more questions? So I think we'll close now. So thank you so much, Ami. That was fun and fascinating and very
exciting. I'm sure it might have been a little overwhelming, but as I said, 1.5 hours is like, people call me like a social media tape recorder. Once you press on, there is no stop till someone asks me to stop.
I tried
sharing whatever I could. I know it could have been a little overwhelming, but I wanted to share whatever things I felt people would be used. It would be
Because it was like, too much of information. Exactly. So you're
exactly
wondering how much you have you actually taken in. So wouldn't mind having another session, I guess.
We will definitely plan. Sure.
Okay.
All right. So here's just a word of thanks, and we thank everybody. So I'd like to take this opportunity to place on record our hearty thanks to Ms. Ami Himani, whose guidance only echoed ignore Instagram at your financial peril. I also extend my thanks to Vandana Maheshwari, National President, and Ms. Madhu Tyagi, National Vice President, for their enormous cooperation, and to our President of Maharashtra Chapter, Shilpi Datta Som, whose impeccable planning skills and bird's eye for details has resulted in making this webinar a success. A big shout out to our social media partner, Chembur Mommies, founded by Ms. Nilma Hinduja. Lastly, I cannot thank you all enough, all you wonderful people, for gracing this session with your presence, and hope to see you in our next event. Thank you. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you so much, everyone.
Thank you.